Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a vlog type thing, and that is because I got a new camera. Yes, so if you guys don't know, it is my birthday next week, and so as an early birthday present, I got a new camera and I'm so excited about it. And so basically in this video I'm going to do a little bit of an unboxing and I'm gonna see how it compares to my old camera and things like that. And so yeah, I don't know, it's kind of going to be a techie video, so if you're not into it, then don't watch it. But I'm so excited because I love when I get new technology. Like, I'm such a nerd, I love technology so much, and I just love anything to do with it, and I love getting new technology, I like to play around with it. I just love technology and electronics and the internet, and honestly, I feel like if I had to give it up, I just would die, because it's my entire life. But yeah, anyway, I'm gonna flip my phone camera around and I'm gonna show you guys the camera, and yeah, we're gonna unbox it. I'm so excited. Literally don't even know how to feel right now. Sorry if I'm talking really fast, but I'm so excited. Okay, let's do this thing. Okay guys, so this is my new camera. It is a Panasonic FZ200 Lumix. Don't really know what that means, but basically I could not get a Canon camera because those are crazy expensive, so I have this one. And I also had to get a new SD card with it because apparently you need a really fancy extreme one and not a regular one. So yeah, this is the box. It's here, it's unopened, it's fabulous, it's brand new. And so yeah, basically, the reason why I picked this one is literally because the guy at the store made it sound convincing, and honestly, I'm really awkward when I talk to shop assistant people, and so I try to avoid it, and I didn't really, like, want to question him or anything, plus it was early in the morning, so I kind of just went with it. And so, this is the one that I ended up getting. I'm gonna have to find a place where I can put my camera so that I can unbox this properly, so give me a second. Okay, so this might not be the most flattering camera angle, but I'm gonna go with it. So I have my box here, as you guys can see, and we're back to front-facing camera so I can see myself, and so this goes well. And so yeah, I'm gonna open it. I already broke the tape. It's surreal, guys. There's no going back. I opened it. Okay. So first thing we have here, dropped something already. The first thing, I think this is the lens cap. So it is. Let me just take it out to show you guys. Fancy lens cap. Magical. And it comes with a little string. I'm going to have to attach that at some point. Yay! And I think, again, a lens cover thing. Also this thing. I think it's another cover thing. I don't really know what this is, but we're going to go with it. Set it there. Okay. So I think this is the camera itself that comes wrapped in a little thing. Okay. So guys, this is my brand new camera. It looks so shiny and so beautiful, and like, it just looks so different from my other one. Let me get my other one to show you guys in comparison. Okay, so this is my other one. This is my Fujifilm. I don't know exactly the make and model of this one, but I'll put it in the description below. But yeah, this is the one that I used to have, and the top of it is very different. And then the back, obviously, you can see that the screen is very much non-movable. But this one, the screen moves. I'm so excited. Okay. So, like I said, even the top of it is different. I don't know what the heck this part is. But I guess I have to discover what that is. But yeah, like, as you guys can see, there's, like, so many more things over here, and, like, there's a separate button for a shutter and this button to record. Like, it's all so magical. I'm just so excited. I love new technology. But yeah, like, as you can see, the bodies of the cameras are definitely different. The lens is huge on this one. I didn't get an extra lens to go with it because I, like, didn't think I needed one. So I didn't get one. And, yeah, like, I don't know. Like I said, you guys can see that this one is definitely bigger than this one. The little thing at the bottom for tripods seems to be about the same. I hope this one fits on my old tripod that I have, because if not, I'm going to have to get a new tripod. But yeah, that's okay. But yeah, so far, comparison, they're kind of the same, except not. I'm going to focus more on the new one than the old one, because well, I liked my old one, it wasn't the best for video, so the guy at the store said this one would be better. So, I'm going to show you guys the back. This is the back, and like I said, the screen comes out. If I could get it out, I'm so scared I'm gonna break it. I don't want to break it, I just got it. Ooh, okay. Okay, so I got it out, finally, and as you can see, it comes out, and it turns. Ooh. For a second there, I thought it didn't turn all the way around, and then I was going to be like, well, that's disappointing. So as you guys can see, the little LED screen comes out, and it turns. So when I'm filming, I can finally see myself. If you guys see my old camera, the screen didn't, like, move or anything. There's no hinge. So I just had to guess where I was in the photo, if I was in frame or not. I never knew. Well, no, if you guys watch me whenever I film, like, over there in my vanity by my window, I used to pull the mirror down so that I could see the reflection. But even then, I was, like, always looking up all the time, so it looks really weird. Sorry, that got in the way. But, like, as you guys can see, the screen comes out and turns, and it's fabulous, and you can turn it back, and then it goes back inside like this. It is very pretty. I love it. I don't suppose this has the battery in it already. Nope. That was so cool. But yeah, the battery goes in here. It does come included with a rechargeable battery. So let's stick out everything else. I just got excited by this. And so, like, I don't even know, guys. Literally, this is me whenever I get new technology. I want to open everything. Okay. So we have our instructions, which are always important because you need these. My hair is, like, really messed up right now. I look kind of crazed. Sorry about that. Two CDs, I guess, to install programs into your computer, which I cannot do. My computer doesn't have a disk drive, because whenever my brother set it up, it's a custom-built PC by my older brother. When he set it up, he didn't put a disk drive in, because I don't need a disk drive, not really, because if I want, like, my Sims games and stuff, they're all, like, digital downloads, so I don't need a disk drive. But things like this, kind of need a disk drive, but you can get them like USB ones, so it should be fine, and I probably won't use these anyway. And then we have a camera strap, which is always very useful because you don't want your camera to fall and die. And then have the rechargeable battery pack thing. The guy told me in the store that I need to originally charge this for like a whole day, so I don't know if I'll be able to do like a video comparison. Like, I don't know if I'll be able to show you guys the difference between filming on my old camera and my new camera, but I will do that at some point. But yeah, little rechargeable thing, which I think is handy, and then the power cable. This must be the battery. I'm so excited. But yeah, let me open you. You know when you break the tape on something, you can't give it back because it just means, like, it's yours. It's official. Don't know how exciting a battery can actually be, but, yeah, that's what it looks like. It's kind of just a battery. Actually, I'm gonna see if I put this in the camera, if there's any charge in it. I don't think that there will be because, you know, it's brand new, but, you know, we're just gonna pop it in there and see what happens. Yep, I think that's it. I'm gonna have to pull the screen out again. Now, the main question I have to ask is, how do you turn it on? Oh, there's a little switch right there. This is the on and off switch. Okay. Learning new things every day. Oh my god, it came on. Okay, it's on. Very low battery. It wants me to set the clock. Let's not. So I'm going to turn this around so you guys can see. This is what I'm shooting right now. Literally. So weird. Inception. But yeah, as you can see, that's what it'll look like. And then, sort of, if I turn it around, I can see myself. This is so weird. You guys can't even see him out of frame. But yeah. Even, like, looking at this, like, through the viewfinder thing, like, I know that this is, like, a better high-quality camera than the one that I currently have. And, like, you can flip the screen around so it's like this as well. You can see me now. Hey. But yeah, like, I don't know. I just want to play around with it so much. I'm just so excited. But now that I know that it works, battery in there and everything. That's good. So I'm going to set that down. I will be able to do a video comparison test in this video then. So bear with me for that. And then the last thing in the box is a little camera USB thing, which I guess is if you want to transfer photos and things. But I just tend to do it it's not really the old-fashioned way. I'll just do it the normal way, which I think is taking the SD card out of the camera and then putting the SD card on your computer, because I feel like that's easier than installing special software for your camera. But yeah, okay. So overall, I'm really happy with this one. I haven't tested it out for like video or anything like that. Like I said, this is brand new and I don't really know that much about it. Literally, whenever I was listening to the shop guy, I was like, you know what, sounds good, I'm gonna go with it. I wasn't really that fussed. Literally my only requirements for this camera were that the screen came out so that I could see myself. That was it. And so yeah, and there's smudges on the little screen already. I don't know if you guys can see. Probably not, but I can see it and that devastates me. But yeah, okay, so that's it right now. I will film two clips on both cameras and I will give you the comparisons and then also photo comparisons. Maybe I'll take a photo and show you guys the difference. But I imagine that this one will be definitely more high quality than this one. But yeah, I'm excited, guys. Are you excited? Let me know in the comments below if you're excited, because this means that my videos will be more high quality. I will always vlog on my phone, though. I feel like the phone camera is good for vlogging and things like that. But for, like, sit-down videos, I'm so excited to start using this. I'm going to take it on holiday with me. You guys are going to be so sick of me spamming you with random things that I've taken with my camera, but I'm so excited. So, yeah. Gonna end the phone part of the vlog, and then I'll come back to you guys at the end. Hey guys! So this is a quick little clip filmed on my Fujifilm camera, which is the camera that I've been using since I started my YouTube channel. I feel like the audio quality is not great when I film with this camera. Also, the image sometimes seems a little bit grainy to me, and it's always hard to tell when you're in focus. And like I said, the viewfinder doesn't come out. So I have my camera set up and my mirror pointed down so that I can see myself. I will actually show you guys the way that I have to sit with my mirror so that I can see to check if I'm in frame. So if I just lift you guys here and turn you around. So this is how I have my vanity thing set up. I set my camera on this because I feel like that is a good height for the camera. And then I have my mirror pointed downward so that I can see my viewfinder to make sure I'm in frame. This is terrible lighting. But yeah. So this is me with my old camera. And now I'm going to film a like little video clip on my new camera. And we'll see how they compare. Okay guys, so this is me filming on my brand new camera and oh my god, it is so hard not to want to look at yourself in the viewfinder because it is such a clear photo. I don't know how the audio quality is on this yet, but I'll obviously be able to tell when I look back at the footage. But yeah, I mean, I just feel like this is so much better already. Like I said, I have a viewfinder, I can see myself, I know how it is. Like I said, guys, I apologize for the mess behind me because you can actually see that with this camera. But yeah, I don't know. This just feels better to me and I'm so excited that I have it now. But yeah, if I lift you guys up and show you sort of this way again, you can see, I don't know how the quality is, like, looking this way. I know my other camera wasn't that great. And like I said, that's my video setup. It looks so attractive. So guys, that was me comparing the two filming qualities of both cameras. I hope that you guys are able to see a clear difference. I haven't looked at them yet. But even when I was sitting down to film them, I could already feel there was such a difference between both of them. For some reason, I feel like my old camera was quite sluggish with video and things. And I think that's because this camera was obviously not meant for filming videos. But I used it for that anyway. And I don't know, like this just feels kind of outdated and slow compared to my new one, which is all fancy and shiny and I'm so overwhelmed by new technology. But yeah. I'm gonna go. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. And like I said, all of the information about both cameras will be in the description below if you want to check that out. And Yeah, let me know in the comments below if you guys are excited for new videos, because I know that I am. And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video. Hopefully better quality. So yeah, bye guys. Hey guys, so today I have decided to restart my Sims 4 Legacy Challenge.